are you?
Alan Turing, one of the best mathematicians in the world.
Welcome to Enigma.
It's the greatest encryption device in history. The Germans use it for all major communications. Over 159 million, million, million possible settings.
It's unbreakable.
Let me try, and we'll know for sure.
So in this movie, you're playing Alan Turing, who was basically the guy who first invented the computer for the purpose of saving lives, ending the war. Then I was wondering if you could remember the first time you used a computer.
Yeah, programming at school, BBC computers, and just sort of learning code and writing very simple basic programs to create sort of worms and movements and patterns and shapes.
The Spectrum, I seem to remember, which was quite a small computer. And I think it might have been on BASIC, I don't really know what I'm talking about. But it had rubber keys.
Oh, nice.
And you used to play, like the first games were like the ball, bat and ball.
Yeah.
That's it.
Commodore 64, home, and programming BASIC, and making your own little games. That was it.
And there was one computer, was it the Amstrad? I was like,
the Amstrad.
I always wanted the Amstrad because it had the built-in.
Joystick.
And then, everything. And then the built-in the CD, whatever the floppy disk for.
Yeah.
The rewards were great if you were good enough at it, to be accurate with the coding. But get one of those things wrong and your worm doesn't work. And you don't want a worm that doesn't work, so it's not fun.
It's the greatest encryption device in history, and the Germans use it for all major communications. If the Allies broke Enigma, well, it would turn into a very short war indeed. Of course, that's what you're working on.
I really love the scenes in these movies where both Alan is applying for a job and Keira Knightley is applying for a job. And I'm wondering if you could think back at the kind of your worst jobs, the jobs you did when you didn't, like when you were between roles.
Yeah, I used to do jetting, so high-powered jetting.
Really?
To clear sewer drains.
I've kind of been very lucky. I have only worked as a director.
Oh, really?
So I can't do anything. I'm hopeless.
I remember once I had a very bad cold and I was doing some gift wrapping in a shop for Richard E. Grant, and I said, "Would you like a bow on that?" And he went, "Yes, please." I mean, he's a hero of mine. With Another Life or something, it was just kind of in my bloodstream from the age of 16 onwards. I could quote every single line of that film. And as I was tying the bow, I just felt this unretrievable run of snot escape my nose, and I couldn't, and it went onto his orange blossom. I don't know what it was that I was wrapping, some kind of present, and I just sort of wiped it off and just sort of started all over again. Mortifying.
Tackled the whole thing at once or divided into small. You finished?
Yes.
Five minutes and 34 seconds.
You said to do it in under six.
Did you guys pick up any puzzle, skills, how to code, break codes and math stuff, things, roles?
I mean, we certainly have. I think we as a group, Matthew Beard was very good at That Means Nothing to Me.
That's lovely. You've got a series of numbers and you've...
Very good. And there's a question mark.
Question mark. I'm going to say, hang on, let me see. Let's see if I can do this. Okay, hang on.
Hold me. What is this? Explain it to me so I can get involved.
It would be 18.
That's correct. Now what if I raised the stakes on you and went and gave you that?
9:36:60, that's a 9:36.
Carry the one,
three,
swarm of peas, red fire truck.
Okay,
no, so it's the 27, 24, or 40, 54. They're,
six, nine.
They're halves. So they're halves of that one. And they're three times. So then it's 15, which makes...
Oh, this is a tough one. You're being mean to me now.
Oh, you have to go.
Oh,
go.
Yeah.
Yeah. Keeping, quickly, so, tell us. What is it?
What is it?
Okay,
so it's...
That plus 15. So this is 15 plus 3 is 18.
Plus 3 is 18.
And then double 18.
Exactly. Yeah, there it is, man.